Hey Fab Girls! In this video, you're going to hear more about the work that I do as a personal stylist and how I use fashion to help women look and feel fabulous. So, the tables are actually being turned on me. And in this interview today, instead of me interviewing somebody, my friend Anna is interviewing me. So take a listen and let me know what you think.
Okay, it's a beautiful day in New York City, and here I am with a talented, amazing, accomplished personal stylist, Tracy Gold. She's internationally known, and she's a star working with just so many women, transforming lives with a personal style.
Thank you.
So Tracy, tell us, please, what kind of people you work with and in what way you are changing their style and how that affects their life.
Okay, thanks, Anna. Thanks so much for having me. So really my focus is working with women over 40. I mean, although I do work with a variety of different people, my focus, especially here in the US, is to work with women over 40. And the reason being is because so many of us have gone through transitions, and it can be a transition of my body is now different, or it can be I'm getting older and I'm not sure how to do this whole thing. Or it can be I've had a baby recently and now suddenly nothing feels the same.
True.
Or I've lost weight and gained weight, or whatever the case is. Or sometimes I've had just a career change going from one role into the other. So I tend to work, women generally come to me when they've gone through a big transition. So either they've been through the big transition or they're about to go through a big transition. And what happens is that they go to their closets and go, whose closet is this anyway? I just don't relate to anything that's in my closet. And then they need some help.
Great, Tracy. So what you do with the women and the closet? So how do you encourage them? Because I know it's a very maybe sensitive topic for many of them. Like someone is coming to their closet, even they trust you professionally.
Yes.
But what would be your first step when you are working with a new client, a woman who is going through the major change in her life and going through the transition? How do you start? What do you start with?
Well, first of all, before I even go into their closets, because I'm very aware, Anna, that for a lot of women, seeking help for a look can be pretty intimidating.
Absolutely.
It can be pretty scary as well.
Yes.
So before we hit the closet, I get to know her as a woman. And I want to know, what does she want to say about herself? What does she like about her look? What's working for her?
Absolutely.
What isn't working for her? And really to just get an understanding of her personal brand, whatever that is. What does she want to say about herself?
Visual representation of her personal brand, which is critically important.
Exactly. Yes. What does she want to say about herself with the way that she looks? Because, you know, she is saying something. Whether
Absolutely.
We're aware of it or not, or whether we like to admit it or not, we are saying quite a lot about ourselves by
the way
we dress. So it's really for me to get to know her and then to also speak about the body shape things. You know, like what are the things that she likes about her body? What are the things she doesn't? And, you know, because I've been working with this for so many years, I mean, I've been a personal stylist for over 15 years and run my own business. Nothing surprises me.
Wow.
And I think that's the great thing.
Is that
women realize,
tell.
Absolutely. So women realize, first of all, they're not alone. That there are so many women who have the same kind of struggles.
Absolutely.
And that's completely normal. And so for me, it's around just helping her to feel comfortable with me.
Very important.
Helping her to trust me and to feel that she's really not going to be pushed into something that isn't right for her, that isn't her.
Absolutely. Tracy, so when you do your work and when you see this amazing result in a transformation, what kind of feeling you experience when you see the woman and what kind of feedback you are getting from the client once they see themselves totally different?
Yes. So, Anna, you know, the thing is that when I look at a woman, I don't see her the way she sees herself. You know, I don't believe that perfection actually even exists. So I think that we can stop comparing ourselves to other women.
Such a relief for so many women.
Absolutely. There's no such thing as perfection. So for me, I just share with my client the way I see her, and then I help her to choose clothing that is going to reflect that, that's going to really draw attention to the beautiful parts of her that she really loves, and kind of just disguise the ones that she's not so crazy about. And I have to say, though, that sometimes it is a process, you know, and sometimes the change happens over a period of time. But what I have experienced time and time and time again is that when women see themselves in clothing that suits their body shape,
yes,
and suits who they are and makes them feel confident, amazing, they feel like a new woman.
Wow.
And it's also equally important to me that she is able to sustain that look. Because, you know, these makeover shows, you see them.
Of course.
And there's an entire team of people to get them to look the way they do.
Totally.
And then they go home. And then what?
Wow.
You know, because then they can't sustain it.
Yes.
And if a woman is growing her personal brand, it's very important that she's able to sustain
consistency
it.
Consistency.
So I make sure.
Yes.
Yeah, so I make sure that she's able to choose the things that she needs to wear for any given event, that the right clothing is in her closet. If I work on hair and makeup, I make sure that she has just the tools that she needs and the products, not a million, because we don't all need a million products and tools. And then that her hair is manageable for her, because there's no purpose to have this wonderful blow-waved hair or fabulous curly hair.
Absolutely.
And you can't do it yourself. And then you just feel discouraged.
Absolutely. Tracy, very important question that
yes,
my audience are dying to hear, because we all have our budget for clothing.
Yes.
How important it is if you're spending thousands of dollars or hundreds of dollars, or you have a budget within $100. So how can you find, is it always important to go for high brands, go to
like
Fifth Avenue? Because a lot of women, they can feel intimidating, say, oh, I'm on a budget. And that is the reason that they kind of pull themselves back from looking fabulous and being their best self.
Anna, let me just say firstly that I have noticed a trend with women over 40 that even if they can afford the designer brands, they often don't value them.
Right.
And I don't believe that you need to spend a huge amount of money to look good. It's
That's
more
great.
About having a very curated closet of things that you really love.
Mm-hmm.
Sometimes it is about spending a little bit more on an item than you would think initially.
Oh, it's kind of investment, I think.
Yeah,
really.
I think some women are scared. You know, they get scared of the price tag, and they associate that the price tag. They say, well, never spend, say, $300 for a pair of pants. Well, that's absolutely fine, because you don't have to. I mean, sometimes you can find really great ones for $50,
absolutely,
you know. So it's not about the price. But if you really struggle to find good pants, and then you find a pair, all the pairs that you've bought that aren't great will definitely go to a greater sum than $300.
Absolutely.
You know, so sometimes it's about determining what are the items that you really struggle with finding, and which are the items that are worth investing in, and which are the things you can just do cheaply. And listen, there are so many amazing shopping opportunities, especially here in New York.
And you know them all?
I know a lot of them. Well, it's impossible to know them all in New York because there's just so much. But there is a lot available for women.
Mm-hmm.
And sometimes even quite designer brands, but at more affordable prices. So for me, I'm always sensitive to a woman's budget. Also, I'm sensitive to what she's comfortable with spending, because the money she has isn't always the money she wants to spend.
Absolutely.
And it's important that she feels comfortable to say, I don't want to buy that. That doesn't work for me. And listen, when women come to me for a makeover, they are under no obligation to buy a single item. Not a single one. Because it's about learning how to shop. It's not necessarily about doing the shopping.
Absolutely, totally agree, because the style is timeless. It's priceless.
Yes.
knowing what is good. So yes. That brings my next question, because yes. we all have different lifestyle, different work environment.
Yes.
And a lot of women, they are making a lot of money working from home.
Yes, which
and
is fabulous.
That brings a problem, a struggle for some women, because mm. home, they just want to be comfortable sitting in their computer, mm. doing things, going maybe to yoga classes,
yes.
and they end up wearing their yoga pants the entire day. And yes. then they have the event to go to, and then becomes a crisis and a problem
yes.
and struggle. How could you deal with that?
Yes.
Helping women to still look fabulous even though they are out of the office environment.
Yeah. So I'm so glad you asked that question, because I'm actually doing a video series on what to wear to work.
Great.
And one of the videos that I'm dealing with is how do you dress when you're working from home?
Yes,
because I
so
also work
important.
From home. So,
right.
you know, I obviously film and I do various different events and I consult with clients. But a lot of times mm-hmm. I am at home from my computer.
Yeah, because in the modern world, we were switching. It's like
correct.
BOD, like bring your own device anywhere.
Exactly. Which
right.
I think is very empowering.
Absolutely.
So one of my tips, Anna, is to, in the morning when you get dressed, and
mm-hmm.
I'm not saying you
okay.
have to do it every morning, because
okay.
I have
worked, taking notes for myself.
I have worked
yes.
from my in my pajamas before, but generally I find that I feel a lot better when I get up in the morning and I get dressed.
Beautiful.
So whatever that is. And the thing is that the clothing and fabric technology
mm-hmm.
has changed such a lot in the last few years
True.
That you don't have to wear uncomfortable clothing to look good.
Yes.
You know, so for instance, this dress that
Good.
I'm wearing here, this is seriously
Love
stretchy.
That.
It is
Beautiful.
seriously stretchy.
It's like the fashion meets function and comfort.
Exactly. And so, you
Love
know,
that.
I'm wearing a belt at the moment, but you know, if I'm working from home and I'm around, I may just lose the belt and then I want to go out, then I'll just put on the belt.
Beautiful.
You know, and then maybe put a different jacket, pair of earrings. So
yes.
it's about having a functional wardrobe.
Amazing.
So if in the case if I'm consulting with you as an example and you're a
yes.
woman who works from home, I would want to know, you know, what business are you doing?
Mm-hmm.
How often are you meeting with clients? How often are you running out if you have kids and you're taking your kids back and forth?
Mm-hmm.
Is your closet functional for you? And is it easy to go from just being at your desk to a networking meeting within two steps maybe?
Oh, absolutely.
And that's
yes.
what's important, because it is possible to do that.
Great.
So you could be wearing a great pair of jeans and a lovely shirt
mm-hmm.
Or a top, and then you just put a jacket on
mm-hmm.
and a pair of heels. Unless you're in New York, then you'll wear a good pair of flats.
Yes, comfortable.
I do not walk in heels. So you don't have to wear heels to look good.
That's beautiful.
I'm adamant about that.
That is a relief mm. because being comfortable and also avoid being sloppy. I think
yes.
that's probably most women
yes.
over 40 would really challenge themselves to.
Yeah.
To
well,
do.
I actually think that most women find
mm-hmm.
that. I mean, even the younger people sometimes, because working environments
oh,
are so
absolutely.
Casual, they often border on sloppy.
Yes.
So I think it's really around, you know, what do you feel good in? So I know I have to be honest. I mean, I have casual clothes, but I don't
mm-hmm.
own any sloppy clothes.
Beautiful.
Not a single thing. And the reason being, because even when I'm at home and I'm on my own, even my PJs, they're not sloppy, because I don't like feeling sloppy.
Mm-hmm.
So, and it doesn't mean I have to be dressed to the nines. No, because like I say, with fabric technology, you can wear stretch fabrics and it'd be super comfortable. And sure, when I go out in the evening or I go out to a really good business meeting or I'm presenting a workshop, I'm going to dress differently to the way I'm dressing at my desk.
Absolutely.
But some of the same components can be mixed and matched.
I love
so
that.
So that it's really simple, actually.
Well, absolutely. But so, and that is probably the way that you can avoid owning 1,000 pieces, because
yes.
living in the city, we don't have big apartments. So it also brings the challenge. So you have to be able to mix and match.
Yes.
So
and let me just say, I just want to share it with you.
Please.
So when I moved to New York, I'm from South Africa, for those
yeah.
of you who don't know. So if you're not sure of this accent, you now know.
Mm-hmm.
So I moved in one suitcase.
Wow, how can you do that?
I don't
Tell
know.
Me.
It was very hard. I shed some tears, I have to be honest. And look, I had fair-sized closets in my South African home. But really what I did was I got very clear on what are the things that I really love
mm-hmm.
and what are the things I really want to wear and
mm-hmm.
I do wear. And I made sure that I could mix and match things.
Mm-hmm.
So like I say, I mean, I go to parties, I go to events, I go to networking events. That's how I met you. I present workshops. I do all these things. And my closet is really well curated that so allows me to do all of those things from that. So there's so many dress up and dress down ideas. So when a woman is going to buy something, there's a kind of rule of thumb that I use. Before you purchase a single item, ask
yourself. Do your homework.
Yes, absolutely. But ask yourself, can I wear this with something that's already in my closet? Mm-hmm. Okay. Can I mix and match it? Mm-hmm. Can I dress it up and dress it down? So let's say for argument's sake, you find a blouse that you really like. Well, if you don't have pants or a skirt or jeans to wear with it, it's not a good buy. No matter how cheap it is. Because then you've got to go find something to buy, to wear with that. And then there's, you know, and then the dog jumps on your pants and ruins your pants and the whole outfit's gone. So rather than choose a blouse that you can wear, oh, this blouse, I can wear with black pants.
Nice.
And I can wear it with a skirt. And I could dress it down with jeans.
Wow.
Now it's a good mix
and match. Have so many different outfits.
Correct. Can
and
I dress?
And you look different using the same items.
And can I dress it up and dress it down? So can I wear a jacket over it? Or can I wear it with a pair of jeans and sneakers and wear it more casually? So there's ways of doing that, but a lot of women don't know how to do these things.
Yeah, especially with accessories, you can play with a lot.
And I think a lot of women don't know how to do these things. And it's also okay that you don't know how, because you can learn.
Oh, of course. Absolutely. Yes, because, well, of course, with a professional like guidance like yourself, I think that makes it a lot more enjoyable, because sometimes it's a struggle when you open your closet and you have nothing to wear.
Yes. Exactly.
It's the crisis that we all often experience as women. So how do you determine which item, if you do the spring, the closet cleaning, I don't know if you really need to do that.
Yes.
But when you open your closet, how you define what I'm keeping, what I'm giving away?
Okay. So first of all, I just want to say that when I do this with my clients, I always start with the positive first. Mm-hmm. So when I first meet with them, I don't look at the entire closet because I don't need to see it. Because you know what's so funny is that women have a lot of the same things in their closet. So I don't need to see the whole thing. Am I right? Right?
Of course.
So what I do is I ask you to just pull out some of the things, you know, before I come that you really love and that you're wearing. Or things that you would love to wear, but for some reason you're not wearing.
Okay.
And then I take a good look at that, and then we decide what works for you, what doesn't, and why. Mm-hmm. Then I take you on a shopping lesson where you really get to try on some things. You learn how to shop properly, because the things are so overwhelming. Yeah. So I use some actual brain strategies.
Oh my God.
On how to narrow down your focus so that when you go shopping, it's not so overwhelming. And these things really do work. So I've done some neuroscience studies and psychology studies on how to narrow your focus so that it's not overwhelming. And so I teach women how to do that. And then we'll come back and look at their closet if necessary. But what I often find is that once we've done our session, they can clear out their closet themselves.
Beautiful.
They're able to
do it. In the privacy of their own home.
Correct. Because especially if they have bought a few things that they really like, they can then compare it. So let's say for argument's sake, they have a jacket that fits them really well. Mm-hmm. Well, now the five other black blazers that don't work, well, they can compare it. Mm-hmm. Does this black blazer fit as well as the new black blazer I bought? No, if it doesn't, well, then they can give it away. And there's tons of thrift stores around in New York or even around the country.
You can just throw in and out and...
Correct. So you can give them away.
Yeah, of course.
You can also give them to friends. So the thing for me is, Anna, I always encourage women to really just let go of what isn't working for them so that they can make space for what is.
Oh, it's so critical, so important. Mm-hmm. It's basically just the transition to the whole new life and opportunities, because that's what I truly believe in. That's it's the energy that you bring and that attracts the career change, personal life, new opportunities, and just makes you the whole new person.
Yes.
Tracy, I truly believe every client of yours is so, so, so lucky. Please tell us how there are women that can find you if they want to work with you personally, how they can work and approach you to know like your professional opinion and just that will lead to transformation.
Sure.
Tell us more.
I know. So I have various packages. So it depends on where people are. I'm based in New York, but if you're based outside the country or even in other states, that's absolutely fine. I work online as well as working in person. Obviously, in person is great because I can take you shopping, and but I even have a package that's called Stylist in Your Pocket.
Love that. Tell us a few more things about that.
I know. Yes. So it's quite cool. So, you know, a lot of times you may not want to spend too much time on, say, a whole day or even a half a day, or you live in a different city other than New York. Listen, New York's a great place to shop, just saying. Absolutely. If you do come on a trip, definitely come in and show you
find
some of the best.
Tracy here, who will take you to all the places to shop.
Yes. But, so what I do with that is that we'll have an online session, so either on Skype, FaceTime, or, I mean, there are so many ways of doing that, and I get a feel of what it is that you're looking for. Mm-hmm. And then I schedule out a couple of hours that I put aside, and we are communicating on WhatsApp. So you go into stores, and you'll take pictures of things, you'll actually try them on, or even video call me so I can see them. And then I'll go, yes, no, yes, okay, now go and look for this kind of thing and that kind of thing rather, and that works really well.
I wish everybody could have this companion, so they
it is so much fun. Wow. And that way it also helps you to teach yourself, it helps you to learn how to shop effectively, because what I find is women spend a lot of money on clothing and still have nothing to wear.
True.
But if you want really the handheld, you know, more of a personal experience, then definitely I have packages for women here in New York. And I mean, with Anna's permission, I'll put my details on my website.
Please.
So it's tracygoldfashiontips.com.
Find them all below.
Mm-hmm. And you can check out my link below. And it's Tracy without an E. So it's T-R-A-C-Y. Mm-hmm. But Google me, you'll find me. So.
Wow, absolutely enjoyed our conversation. So basically, the basic line is the most expensive clothing is something that you never wear. And
that is it.
Basically, investing in the personal stylist can actually be the best investment in your life, because with the right closet, with all the calculated items in your closet, you can look fabulous on a budget.
Yes. Absolutely.
Great pleasure to talk, Tracy. So I'm looking forward for more. So we'll continue the series about the styling, about the branding, about the transformation. So everybody, thank you so much for watching. And it's a great honor to bring valuable guests like Tracy Gold in New York City. So we'll continue talking more about the personal branding and exploring the opportunities, the transformations, and the change it can make in your life.
Awesome.
thank you.
Bye. That was amazing.
Really? Just my interview?